of industrialization. But that's a double-edged sword. So it hasn't had the huge capital made by industry, but it has had money made by agriculture. And it also is in beautiful condition. So the Republic of Ireland, in terms of the actual condition of all the organic matter, you don't have the same brownfield sites. Your agriculture is in good nick, etc., etc. God save the Queen. We get more from Westminster than we make in tax revenue. Fact. Sebastian, yes, that's actually 100% untrue. So there's no fact there at all. That's what you've had your tiny little head stuffed with. So come on, listen to Scotty McClure, and I'll give you fact. All right. Skexit means a hard border, no currency, no trade deals, isolationist, narrow nationalism. Sebastian, again, 100% whopper. I'm going to call you not Sebastian, but Pinocchio. Pinocchio, because Skexit, no reason for a hard border, no currency, we can either use sterling, the pound Scots, the euro, you know, the smackaroonie, doesn't matter. No trade deals, are you absolutely kidding? Are you saying nobody wants water, nobody wants whiskey, nobody wants power, nobody wants oil, and nobody wants gas, nobody wants food? Is this what you're telling us, you know? Nobody wants, yep, the whole lot. That's because the Brits came over and ruined our cultural country. Stare, you're not listening to me. The Brits haven't even touched the Republic, right? Not even touched it. No industrialization to speak of. Had the Brits, as you'd call them, the people, the English people, that occupy the bottom half of the landmass of Britain, had they come over and industrialized you, you would have known all about it. What I'm saying is, you're an excellent nick. You can't point the finger at all at that. So there you are. And also, would it have helped if Michael had asked Trevelyan if he could have enough corn to feed the wee one? Do you see what I'm saying? Play with the heat stare here and watch McClure. This is...